Hi guys, how's it going? This is Pawan Mehr and I want to inform you that Digital Deepak took money from me for an internship. Why would anyone take money for an internship, especially someone like Digital Deepak who himself is a brand in the digital marketing space? So just hold on for a few more minutes and I'll just explain you why he actually took money from me, alright? The very first reason is that they want us to learn. They want us to learn each and everything which they have included in the curriculum without missing anything at all. Now the thing with online courses or any other online program is that people enroll in it, but they fail to complete it, or they just complete 10 or 15 or 20% of the entire curriculum and then they'll drop out. So that is the exact reason why there is a particular amount which is paid in the internship, and I'll explain you as well as to why that particular amount is taken as a deposit and how it is actually taken care of. So just a few more minutes, guys. So first of all, I'll talk about the structure of the internship program, all right? So the entire internship program is divided into 16 weeks. That is, each and every week, you will be taught a particular topic, be it SEO, be it Facebook ads, Google ads, or whatever. So there would be 16 broad topics in total, and for each and every week you would be given an assignment to solve. Alright, so as in when you actually learn that particular week's topic, you would also be asked to solve an assignment which will ensure that whatever you have learned from the video is actually taken care of by doing everything in practical. So that is how it goes. 16 weeks, 16 assignments, 16 videos. Alright, now coming on to the objective which you have as to why you want to join the internship program if and when you decide to enroll in it. So people basically here come for different objectives, such as to find a job or become a freelancer, or to enhance their current business by shifting them to the traditional medium, to the digital medium. So that is what the objectives are. So in the program itself, you are actually compelled to do certain assignments in such a way that it will help you understand what is your objective, right? So you will be first of all compelled to select your niche as to what particular area of interest do you have. So let's say in digital marketing, what do you actually want to achieve in digital marketing? So if you want to become an SEO expert, then you would be given a particular chance to select that as a niche, and then all your assignments which will come in the future would be accordingly solved. So let's say you have taken SEO for interior industry for that matter, then that would be your niche, and all the rest of the assignments which are there out of 16 weeks would be actually solved in that manner. So that's there. Now what have I learned so far? So I would like to let you know that first of all, I was not clear at all about my niche, all right? So I was actually wanting to do something in the food domain. However, I did not know as to what to particularly do in the food domain. That's when the assignment three as to taking your or selecting your profitable niche come into the picture. It actually helped me to identify what I want to actually achieve in the food industry, and that's when I took vegan food as my particular niche in the program itself. So once I took my niche, all my assignments were actually focused, really focused, and that helps me enhance all my marketing efforts. And the blog which I have, natureswalk.in, all the content which is put up on there, it is actually a result of the assignments which are ongoing in the internship program. So yeah, so I've learned some insane topics about marketing already, like the CATT framework, which is completely new to me, and I'm sure you also might not have heard about it. So it mentions that the profitability of your niche is directly raised to the power of CATT, which is content, attention, trust, and transaction. All right, so if you want to understand more about that particular topic, I'm sure there are certain blogs which are explaining this particular topic on Digital Deepak's website, right? So you should definitely have a look at that. Deepak also makes us realize that marketing doesn't mean social media, all right? So there are a lot of different aspects to marketing, or digital marketing for that matter, right? So a lot of people actually focus just on social media and they want to increase their followings and they want to just garner likes and everything, but that is not really marketing. you should be actually having your own blog, you should be having your own list of email subscribers, you should be having your own courses, which is actually directed in or which is actually resting on your own website. It's because the thing with these social platforms is that someday or the other, as and when the popularity of these social media channels increases, the reach which you'd be getting would be decreasing as well. So it is inversely proportional to the popularity of that particular platform. So as and when, you must have noticed with Instagram also. So earlier you used to get a lot of likes if your profile was public, but now if you are trying to create a public profile and you try to put up things out there, you would not be getting as many likes or as many shares, or you might not be getting that many interaction with your content. The reason is, as and when, as I mentioned, the popularity increases, your interaction with your particular profile and post would decrease drastically. So it is absolutely vital to have your own universe, wherein you have your own blog, your own email list, wherein you have your own courses, so that you can completely keep on posting new stuff and people are updated with your content. And it's your own web property, right? Your email list cannot be stolen by anyone, or no particular platform can actually ban you, just in case if you put up some content which is unintentionally violating that particular platform's rules or regulations. So yeah, that's there. Another amazing thing which happened with me was that I actually conducted my own webinar, all right, and that too, that was with Mrs. Anjali Thadani, which is who is a health food chef, and she has served a lot of Bollywood celebrities, and the kind of traction and the kind of comments and the positive feedback that we got was really, really insane. And no one actually felt that I was doing it for the first time. So it was actually my first event, yet I was able to do it with real ease. And I would not have done it for sure, because I always felt that I did not have all the knowledge about vegan culture and everything yet. So I would have waited for another 6 months or something to actually conduct such a webinar. But the assignment in the internship program actually compelled us to create or conduct your own webinar, so that you have that kind of an experience and you get a lot of leads and you get a lot of new interactions and your popularity increases. So that was another amazing thing which has happened in the internship program for me. So yeah, I would say it is more than a course. All right, so now I'll talk about the payment structure as to why did Deepak charge me to get into an internship. So I'll tell you what. So what happens is, you actually put in a deposit, right? Let's say X amount. And what happens is, this particular X amount is divided into 16 equal installments, or 16 equal parts. Let's say 16 equal parts. So what happens is, as and when you complete one particular week's assignment, you would be actually required to upload that particular assignment in the learning management system. Once it gets approved, you would be getting a cashback for that assignment. All right. So as and when you complete the program, you would be receiving your cashback. So let's say I complete my program, this week's assignment and submit it. And once it gets approved, I would be getting a cashback for that particular week. So it just happened that I got my week 7's cashback yesterday itself. So every week I'm getting money back into my account. So technically, if you complete the entire program and submit all the assignments, you would be doing the internship program for free. The internship program is practically free, all right? And it is insane, because you would be having a kind of a stick on your back that you have to complete that particular assignment. Otherwise, if you do not complete it and do not submit it, you'd be losing that week's amount, right? So you would not be receiving any cashback for that particular week. So you have that kind of a fear in your head that you have to complete it, and that's what the trick is, right? So he is actually compelling us to do these assignments so that we do not lose out on any money. So it's an insane structure he has built up. And not to worry, there are weekly calls which happen. So let's say a particular week's assignment is released. So every Tuesday we actually get on a weekly call with our mentor, all right? And he actually solves or rather he guides us on each and every question which is there in the assignment, so that each and every individual can solve the assignment smoothly. And mind you, the assignment approval rate is 100%, so just in case if you are doing something wrong in your assignment, you will get a feedback. Your assignment would be asked to re-upload it once you have made the changes, and yeah, you would be definitely getting your cash back. So the assignment approval rate is 100% as far as you are doing the assignments and doing it correctly. So that's there. And if you're not doing it correctly, you would be given a feedback, as I mentioned, and then you'd be asked to re-upload again. So yeah. And once you get in the into the program, you will notice that it's a community of like-minded people. So we have a group on Telegram, all right? So we actually interact on a daily basis. So if I have any doubt, I just put on my Telegram group, and there are about 400 to 500 people who are there in this particular Telegram group. And for any particular question that I put in, I definitely get answer for that within minutes, right? So the kind of support we get from each other is insane, and also from the mentors which are assigned to us. So again, the community which course offers of like-minded people is something you should really, really look out for. So that's there. So now, what kind of opportunities do people get once they complete the program? So I want to let you know that it's been just about 6 to 7 weeks which we have completed in the batch 6 of internship program, and 3 or 4 people already have got job offers, alright, just because of the fact that they have had hands-on experience, hands-on knowledge about the concepts which are taught in the Digital Deepak internship program, alright. So the concepts which are taught in the program are absolutely applicable to real life. So there's no theory at all, everything is hands-on, everything is practical. You have to do it on your own, you have to create your own blog, you have to stuff on Facebook, you have to run Facebook ads, you have to do Google ads. Everything is actually hands-on. So just because of the fact that you get hands-on experience, you have that weightage in front of other candidates who have done the courses but only in theory. So if you have that kind of a practical experience, you are 100 times better than people who do not have that practical experience. So again, that was an advantage for a lot of people. And also, a lot of people have got freelancing opportunities. A couple of people have also got companies who have approached them, and these companies are based overseas. So people have already got international projects as well to do as a freelancer. So there are hell lot of opportunities which are there in the internship program. And as a matter of fact, Deepak also absorbs some of the interns for his own company as well. So if you are really good at your work, you might as well become an employee at Digital Deepak's company, which is Pixeltrack. So you get that particular opportunity as well. So the opportunities with the program are actually insane, and you are going to open a lot many doors to the world of digital marketing. Long story short, if you want to make it big in the digital marketing space, the internship program is the ultimate hack for you. There's no other way to it. You just have to get into the program, get all the knowledge, and you're actually getting it for free. So why not just do it? I mean, I'm actually 100 times better with my marketing skills, with my digital marketing skills, and it's just been 7 weeks until now. There are 8 more weeks which are still pending. And the kind of confidence which I have in the marketing space and the digital marketing space right now is something I'm really proud of. So just get into it. Just get into it. So yeah, guys, this is what my review is for the Digital Deepak internship program. And if you have any questions or any doubts, please do mention them in the comment section. I would be more than happy to help. And just in case you want to get on a call or do a chat on WhatsApp, please do mention that as well. I would be more than happy to solve any sorts of questions for you. Alright guys, cheers.